Hi there. Welcome to 20 for 20. My name is Kathleen Draper with the Elks National Foundation. Today, I'm joined by Makenna Turner, a 2020 Top 20 Most Valuable Student Scholar, sponsored by Boulder, Colorado, Lodge number 566. Thank you so much for joining us today, Makenna. First, I'll just have you introduce yourself and tell us a little bit more about you and where you're from.
So, hello, my name is Makenna. I am from Boulder, Colorado. Actually, I'm from the outskirts of Boulder, Colorado. I'm from Lafayette. And next year, I'll be attending Stanford University to study computer science.
That's so exciting. How did you choose that field of study?
I kind of fell into it. So for so long looking for a creative outlet for myself. Mm-hmm. And I kind of just stumbled into the world of technology in eighth grade. I decided that I was going to learn how to reverse engineer the Fitbit. And ever since I worked to self-study that and taught myself how to solder and code, it's really just been an outlet for myself to express my creativity. And I really love web design, web development, back-end data. I think it's just so interesting and there's so many applications for it.
That's really cool. So a big part of being an Elk Scholar and obviously your high school experience and probably your college experience is service. So what does service mean to you?
Service can mean so many different things to me. I like to do service in every single aspect of my life, not because I feel like I'm obligated to, but because I truly enjoy giving back to my community and teaching people the things that I love. And one of the biggest ways that I've been able to give back and serve my community is by teaching other people about computer science and STEM. So I've run multiple computer science clubs in my school. I helped run the robotics club. I started the Computer Science Honor Society. And I also ran a campaign for students in Puerto Rico to get educational supplies after Hurricane Maria. And for me, service, I like to think of it as educational. Education is the key that unlocks so many different doors in this world. And I like to serve by giving back in any educational way possible.
That's amazing. And you just talked about so many huge achievements that you've made in that realm, but what would you say your proudest achievement is?
I think it would definitely be the Backpacks for Puerto Rico campaign that I ran my sophomore year. That took a lot of coordination. I mean, across the country, I had donations coming in from different states. I had to make sure that the donations got to Puerto Rico and got to the children and families in need. So that was probably my biggest accomplishment, especially because I ran it on my own and had to coordinate with so many different people. There were language barriers and just so many different things to consider in that.
Yeah, that sounds really intense and like a lot of work, but that's amazing that you were able to coordinate all that, especially as a high school student.
Yeah, it's super rewarding, super rewarding.
It sounds like it. And what is being an Elk Scholar going to help you do?
Elks, they have so many different opportunities for me to really give back even further to my community. And especially as a college student, I was wondering, like, how will I be able to continue to serve in a new place? But Elks Lodges, they're just everywhere. And there are Elks members literally everywhere. So I plan on being able to give back through the Elks organization. And I think Elks, the core of what Elks are is people who serve. And I'm just so excited to be able to do that with Elks Lodges and my fellow Elks Scholars.
Yeah, it's great that there's so many lodges, especially where you're headed to in California as well, and they're all so involved in the community. And what was your favorite part of the Top 20 Virtual Leadership Weekend that we had at the end of April?
I think my favorite part was seeing everybody. So we had to make these like shields, and it was talking about like the things that matter most to us or what makes us us. And I really loved seeing how creative everybody else was. Mine was really not creative. Mine was actually really bad. But everybody else's was so pretty and well thought out. And just, it was so interesting to see what people thought were the pillars of who they were.
I really enjoyed that part. It was my first leadership weekend. And I thought that was so amazing and such a great way to get to know everybody as a staff member at the ENF. But I'm sure it was such a great way to get to know everybody as another top 20 scholar. And what were you doing when you found out that you were a top 20 MVS scholar?
What was I doing? Oh my gosh, I was so surprised. That was like the most surprising thing this whole year that happened to me. And I was just sitting on my computer and I saw an email come through and it said, congratulations, like you're an Elks. And I was like, oh, whoa. I didn't know that was coming out, and I definitely didn't think I was going to win it. So it was just super exciting, and I went to call my mom, and she didn't pick up. So I, like, ran out of my house, and I, like, looked around, and my grandma, she was out there, and I was like, I won a scholarship, and I was so excited.
That's so exciting. That's such a huge moment in your life and as you head off to college, too. And what makes you an Elk Scholar?
I've said this before, is the service aspect. Elk Scholars, every person I've met through the Elks organization, our one thing that we love most and the one thing that we really share is service. And we love to be able to give back, not all the same way, but in the ways that we find meaningful to ourselves. And so for me, I think it's definitely wanting to serve my community and also being able to meet other Elk Scholars and wanting to serve with them. We serve as a community for our communities. So I think that's what really makes me an Elk Scholar and makes other people Elk Scholars as well.
I love that. And you obviously are very passionate about service, and you talked a lot about how computer science not only is going to be your field of study and a career, but is something that you're passionate about kind of as a hobby. But what is something else you might be passionate about outside of academics and service?
My strangest hobby, I would say, is beekeeping. I have bees in my backyard, actually, like right outside there. And that is one of those like kind of strange hobbies I fell into. I decided I was going to become a beekeeper a couple years ago. And it was after visiting I was on a college visit. And our tour actually ran into somebody who ran a bee lab. They're a researcher. And they talked all about the bees and how interesting it was to research them. And I was like, oh, that does sound pretty cool. And so I decided to go home and like look into it on my own and do some research. And I actually was volunteering at a homeless shelter, the Boulder Homeless Shelter. And by coincidence, a woman came in to give a presentation, and she was a local beekeeper. And she was talking about how she does beekeeping and all these different things about bees. And she mentioned that she also does a class for the Boulder County Beekeepers Association. And so I was like, oh, that's sick. And I ended up signing up for the class and decided to become a beekeeper after I finished all those classes.
That is so much fun. That is totally something I could see myself doing too. And do you make your own honey or anything like that?
Yeah, I've tried not to rob the bee. I've tried the honey. It's pretty good. I try not to rob them. The bees that I have this year are relatively new. They're young bees and they're young hive. So I'm not stealing from them yet, though I am very inclined to.
I bet. I'm sure it's delicious. And if there was anything that you could say to the Elks, what would you say?
Thank you. I mean, not just for this scholarship, but for everything that you all do in this community. I mean, you stretch worldwide, and your goal is to give back to people. And I think that's so important. And I think the way that people serve their communities is many times overlooked, and especially all the things that Elks Lodges do to serve the community. And so my message to Elks is just a thank you for everything that you guys choose to do behind the scenes that doesn't always get recognized, because it's so important and it's really a pillar of every community.
Well, thank you so much, Makenna. Thank you to all of our viewers for tuning in. If you like the show, hit the like button below and be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you so much for helping us build stronger communities and connecting with the Elks family. See you next time.